So, Spa-Francorchamps, engine goes well, car is good, but I'm a little cautious. Welcome to the Ultimus Dealer YouTube channel. This is all about owning and using a classic Italian sports car. Remember, this is my opinion, but if you get it, I love it. After 2 days in nice sunny weather on the Nürburgring, we turned westwards towards Spa, where we found a nice hotel with good parking, and you know, they had good beer, right?
Very early morning, Monday, going to Spa, with reserved parking. Good. Ooh, GTA. And up here I have Angry Giulietta waiting, idling, and we were told to get in early. We have the first spot in the line, and it's not very long. So this is where we'll get our credentials and our morning coffee. Right up there is Eau Rouge.
But there was one thing that I didn't prepare Mikkel for. Anyway, we went out to the cars and applied the stickers, voila, and talked about how we should attack the famous racetrack. It was Mikkel's first time here, and I've been here a couple of times.
So this is the time schedule of the day. We are here, early arrivals, registration, driver's briefing, and then Mikkel will go out in the GTA at 20 minutes past 9, roughly. And then 10:45, I'll go out. And then we have a 1 hour lunch break, middle of the day. And then it continues in the afternoon, and there's some open pit lane after 3 o'clock. And we can stay until 10 in the evening. How about that, Mikkel?
Yeah.
I think we'll find a sneaky restaurant in Spa City.
Was an Fahrzeugen noch kommt, weil Sie wissen selber, aus Rennveranstaltungen nicht jeder sieht die gelbe Fahne dann, wenn er sie sehen soll oder wenn er sehen möchte.
So after a good solid briefing, we went out into the paddock again, and lots of people had arrived during the early morning. How about this, by the way, for a good tow car? An Alpha 6. The Alpha C, this one is injected, but how about 6 single carburetors? Everybody went out to the Eau Rouge Hill for a group photography session. Really good idea. I was surprised to see how rough the tarmac surface was, unlike some of the other important details of the day. So we went for the first lap in Mikkel's car, because the road cars without roll cages were the first cars to go on to the track. This is his first time through the Eau Rouge. Woo! The Alpha 156 GTA is the perfect car for a track day like this on an F1 track. This is, of course, not your ordinary F1 track. It's a bit more hilly. I can really see why it's the Formula 1 driver's favorite track of the season. Now let's listen to the wonderful engine and see how Mikkel does it. This, by the way, is his first proper lap. That helmet brings up the competitor. But look at this nice picture he got. Next up were the racers, and we did the same drill, queuing up one by one and getting a good photography from that red car, both out of the rear hatch. And another guy on top through the sunroof. Nice pictures, huh? So it was time for some lunch, and Kent and Per Hahn, the non-alpha guys, arrived. So we went into Francorchamps to get some nice local specialties.
Omelette.
Yeah. Omelette. Stor omelette.
Bare så I ved det.
Croque monsieur.
Og en petit bière.
Turns out my car was not the oldest one. This one was a 1957 Spider, made a bit like a competizione. He's from Sweden, and was that a GoPro on the rear of the car? Watch his full video from a link in the description below. So now I'm about to collect some water. Not for me, I'm not that thirsty, but angry Julieta is. The engine simply burped out a liter of water. I don't know from where. It might have lifted the lid.
I'll idle the car and slowly fill up the water without the cap on. So, hope this will solve the problem. Now to the laboratories.
I had a lot of people come over and participate in the examination of poor angry Giulietta. Thank you a lot for that, guys. Some knew me from the Ultimo Stile website or by videos, and others just came over out of curiosity. We borrowed parts and everybody gave their opinion, and in the end we found out that the ignition timing profile is simply wrong. Just as at the Nürburgring, it was only more pronounced at Spa-Francorchamps, which is a more tough circuit to drive. And then amidst the worst trouble, we got some proper help. During all the fiddling, we established that we could not retard the ignition because the car would be impossible to drive at slow speeds and get going. So we just tightened the spring in the radiator cap and did a lot of driving around in the paddock and the different connection roads through the inlands of the racetrack. But in the end, we had to go and test it on the track. So I went out again and with Pierre Han, my main mechanic, this time to check if it had any impact on the behavior of the car.
Jeg vil gerne betale de 3.000 kroner, det koster, for at få bilen med hjem. Forstår du, hvad jeg mener?
Ja, absolut.
So, as I'm telling Per Han here, I'd rather take the car home, and I don't really bother having paid the 400 euro to participate, because I see it as an insurance ready to get the car back home with me in one piece. We can look for the exact problem when I get home.
Det ændrede ikke rigtig noget.
Og det gør jo, at vandet ikke pisser ud af den formel.
Det får vi jo se.
So, time to go home. Mikkel had a really good day and he drove a lot of laps on the track. But everybody, I suppose, were satisfied. We went back to Spa to get some proper food and some proper beer.
You kept, man.
And in the morning, we took our time, got a good breakfast, and drove with me as the lead car. If something should happen, we kept a nice pace around 130 kilometers per hour. And arrived at Stefan's place, all very tired after the long drive. And Stefan, as he said, next time I'm also going, because there seems to be problems every time. I was home just before midnight, I parked the car, and the next day I drove back to the garage. Home again. And in the meantime, I've got a new neighbor. Klaus Reich here in the Ferrari 308, and there's Holmens Berliner. And Dan has got his Dino engine back. How about that? You can't travel abroad without wonders and crazy things happening in the garage. Wow, that's fantastic. Japanese. So, see you next time.
Le bon, le bien, l'autre, c'est...